I'm going to start with the using a C6 3D embossing folder, and I'm going to make sure that I have the back, the one with the indentations. All right, so I'm going to be using two colors, and I want, let's see, this is the purple one. Pretty much soft. Don't push too hard because then you will go into the indentations and you don't want that. Very soft. And the pink. Fade into the white of the card. All right. Then I get my card. Awesome. I love it. Okay. What I intended to do was the white at the bottom, so I'm gonna do it again with another. Let me clean this up. It can be so confusing sometimes. I want the bottom to be white, so I have to start over here. This is the friendly flowers from Simon Says Stamps, and I wanna what I want to try is see if that embossing powder sticks to this oxide. I'm so hoping it does. I think I have to work quick with it. I didn't use the powder and that's bad, but it's transparent, so let's hope that it's not that bad. I just always forget something, don't we all? And let's do this. Good work. Amazing. Oh, I love that. I love it. All right, so that one is going on this one. I'm going to cut it a little bit more. And to this one, should I do the pink? This is from Ginique Hearts. I am going to trim it, an eighth of an inch around. Set a bit. our base, that is 4¼ by, well, this is, what is it, 11? So that is a 5½ score. And very clean. And then get some glue. Two cards, very easy. This is from CZ Zazzy Flaps, and I am going to the card. And another thing that I did try out, I made the embossing and then I colored with Copics, and I just love it. It's just so beautiful. So that's something that you also can do with embossing folders. So I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time. Bye!